North Korea's promise to shut down its Yongbyon nuke complex, just how significant would that be? Remarkable is the answer, according to a leading American nuclear scientist. I'm Alex Jensen for North Korea Now. Looking closer today at the significance of this nuclear facility, which Chairman Kim Jong-un vowed to close when he met with South Korean President Moon Jae-in last week. I should add here that the promise is dependent on American corresponding measures, and negotiations are ongoing on that front. Detractors have been dismissing Chairman Kim's offer, saying the complex is outdated and of little strategic value. But the renowned expert I referred to before, Siegfried S. Hecker of Stanford University, known for his direct experience with Pyongyang's nuclear program, has told an audience in Seoul that Yongbyon's closure would be amazing because they have several things in there that he knows they pride enormously. The facilities may be old, he added, but they are functional, and North Korea is still making more plutonium. So Yongbyon would be an important step, and plutonium is a key material for making nuclear weapons. What else do we know? Let's take a closer look at this complex. It reportedly has more than 390 buildings, and three of them, a 5-megawatt electric reactor, a radiochemistry lab, also known as a reprocessing facility, and a nuclear fuel rod production facility, have been mentioned as the first to be destroyed. They did all actually undergo a disabling process under a 2007 Six Nation Agreement, but Yongbyon has expanded since that deal fell apart. In fact, nuclear experts in Seoul believe Yongbyon's uranium enrichment plant has grown so much that the number of centrifuges there is estimated to have doubled to over 2,000. The key question remains for negotiators: how much of the complex would actually be dismantled? And what about other sites that may be in use for uranium enrichment and the production of hydrogen bombs?